Hey guys, good morning. So please forgive my mess because y'all know everything around here is like looks crazy, but it's all gonna come together. Anyway, just sharing shade cloth with you real quick. I would recommend if you are gonna get shade cloth, the best way to get shade cloth is to go within the farming community if you can get to one of those vendors, because they have it in big, huge rolls. It's less expensive depending on how much you need. If it's just you, residential, and you just need a small piece, you can do it on Amazon, Amazon, and you could do the big box stores, Home Depot, Lowe's, whatever. It's Sunday morning, and I'm already tired, and I'm on my way to go to work. But anyway, so yeah, shade cloth is a thing. So I have this that is 20 by 20 by 20. So the plan is for it to span almost the entire rear of the home. So it's gonna span from the back of the house going all the way over. And the reason why it looks so messy here draped like this is because temporarily, until I properly mount it, I took a 10 by 10, which is one of these little pop-up tents. Summer's over, so they should be $50 now, $45 in Walmart or wherever. So I just took one of these, put the topper back in the bag, and I just threw this shade cloth on top of it. This is a 40% shade cloth, as you can see. So it has these little kind of holes in there, and it does let the sun through. So, but it shades it out at 40%. The other wonderful thing is it lets rain through. So that was very important. So make sure when you're buying your shade cloth that it will let rain through, if that's what you want. I wanted that because I want my plants, my tropicals, to be outside, but I also don't want them to burn. What was happening is tropical plants, because we don't talk about tropicals all the time lately, because I am working on the farm and I've been really focusing on the veggies and the build out of the farm and the bus. So tropicals have been on the back burner just for a second. So I'm sorry, guys. So they have been. So I've been hiding them under chairs and behind other plants and stuff, and they have been getting beat up. The reason why tropicals get like this sometimes is because in a tropical forest setting, you have the large trees that are at the top of the rainforest, and then the understory plants, the ones that are on the bottom floor, are these guys. They don't get a lot of sun because they're on the bottom, so they're not exposed to that bright sun. So when they are, they start getting sunburned and crispy and things like that. Even one of my orchids burned up. Is just all burnt. There it is. That is sunburn on that orchid. So what was happening is over time, them being outside in different places, I'm trying to hide them in a tree, hide them. And I was just ruining my tropicals. Plus for 1 year and some more time, 1 year and a few months, I did not have a home. So I was like, can I put this at your house? Da, da, da. Over time, I was still trying to collect and still trying to build, because I knew that I was going to get to a place where I was going to build myself back up. So these plants have just been everywhere and all over the place. So now that I'm trying to put everybody into one space, I needed them to be safe from that bright, bright sun. So shade cloth has 40% shade from the sun. So now they can be out here outside in the rain, so they can get that good rainwater. They can get this humidity. They can get the bright sunlight that I'm on, eastern facing. So they're getting the morning sun, the 9 a.m. sun, and then the 12, and then it goes on over to the other side of the house. So they're getting bright morning. It's great. They wake up, have a wonderful morning. So now I'm getting far less burns, far more beautiful leaves. I'm getting, far more new babies. I'm getting a lot more growth, and they're so much happier that they're under here and protected by this shade cloth. And it was just super cheap because I just got a little 10 by 10, threw this over here temporarily until I can properly mount it. So if you guys are having issues with things that need shade, certain plants, I do have like Brussels sprouts over here because my Brussels sprouts were also suffering, you know, so I got my Brussels sprouts under there. I've got my Hindu rope, which is a Hoya. Hindu rope was getting charred out there in the sunlight. So a couple of things that I had in here. I don't know if I showed you the sunburn, even on some of my orchids. But now everybody's jumping up. The Birkin jumping up. Gloriosum is popping, jumping up. So everybody's feeling a little bit better now that they're under here and they're protected. So if you are interested in getting shade cloth, they do come with grommets so you can easily mount them. You can buy them in different sizes. For this 10 by 10, I bought a 20 by 20 by 20 for what I need anyway. But you want to get it a little bigger because you can rip these easily. So you don't want to do that. If you're going to use this as your permanent structure, I'm not. So I just got what I wanted and just threw it over. But if you're going to use this as your permanent structure, get it a little bit bigger. Or what I did before when I used this is I took blanket and I just cut little pieces of blanket and put it over all of the little Sharpie edges. So when this laid on there, it just touched the blanket. But I'm not using this permanently. It's just so that my plants can be okay for a little bit until I can get them, get this mounted properly and they can have their permanent place under here. Under my shade cloth is where, I mean my shade area is where I usually grow my new seedlings, my new babies, get them hardened off to where they can go outside into the real world where the real harsh sun is. But these guys can't be out there. All of these things, when you're looking at your fiddly figs, when you see this, how she's so much lighter than maybe this, you see the difference in color because this was didn't get enough light. But then when you start seeing things like this, that's sunburn. I don't know if he has any sunburn. But yeah, definitely plants do get sunburn if they're not used to bright, direct light, depending on where they come from or where they live, where they're used to growing. So think about shade cloth. If you don't need a lot and you're just residential, just need a small piece, Amazon.com or Home Depot. I think Home Depot has it in rolls as well. So you can look into that. But shade cloth does really come in handy for your tropicals if you got to put some outside, because sometimes if you put them outside, it gives them a chance to sort of, you know, strengthen up, because in the house, you know, you don't have the humidity and you don't have the, you know, the light, and sometimes you don't have the rainwater and stuff like that. So yeah, like this lady, this is a pink princess, and they all look dusty because they live outside. But I wasn't getting a new leaf on this for like months and months. This was a cutting and it was doing nothing. And it's been outside for a week and it's, you know, like, yes, thank you, you know. So it's wonderful. Look, this guy's already, I just brought this Mexicana. I like these leaves. Look at this. Don't get me talking about tropicals. Don't think just because I'm into veggies that I love tropicals. Look at the back of that. That's so pretty. Hey, listen. She just got here. Good Lord. But yeah, this Mexicana I've been having inside for the last, I don't know how many months, and she's not giving any leaves. So I figure, hey, let's throw her out here and see if that's what's wrong. If she just needs some more humidity. Because she came, and this is a cutting too. And she was just going, and then she just stopped. So I'm going to see if if this is what she needed. But a lot of these plants that were kind of like suffering and getting burnt up are now coming back in full force because they're out here under the shade cloth, so they can get, you know, everything they want outside without getting burnt up. So shade cloth is a thing, people. I don't remember where I got this from, but yeah, I do see it on Amazon. So I can't tell you which one I got, sorry, but it doesn't really matter. 40% is pretty decent for my tropicals, but if you want to go all the way to 50, you can. And then some people want only need like 10 or 20. So do your research, as I always say, because I don't ever claim to be the one who knows everything. So yeah, I just make these suggestions, but do your own research and see what's going to work for you. But I do recommend that if you have space for it and you could put some shade cloth, you should do it. All right, guys. Happy Sunday. Bye.